welcome to Space with Sarah. I have mentioned in a few earlier videos that the elements in everything they make up, including us, the Earth, and all the stars, are produced within the cores of stars and in their explosions. These stars need to actually die to spread the elements into space. That's not the only way to produce elements. For example, most of the hydrogen and helium in the universe was produced in the Big Bang. Other processes, such as collisions between very dense neutron stars, have been hypothesized to produce other specific elements. However, what we haven't discussed in detail is what do humans consist of? And does it make sense that we consist of what we consist of? Here's what we find when we look at this question by number of atoms in the human body. First of all, our body is made up of roughly 10 to the 28 atoms, hence a 1 with 28 zeros after number of atoms. A crazy amount. Of all these atoms, 63% of them are hydrogen, 25% of them are oxygen, 9% of them are carbon, and 2% of them are nitrogen. The last 1% is made up of potassium, sulfur, sodium, and some other elements. You can also hear this as, we're mostly made of water and carbon. But what is the universe made of? Or more precisely, what elements are there most of from the periodic table? It turns out that the universe is made of 75% hydrogen and 25% helium, a little less. And the next most abundant elements are then oxygen, carbon, neon, iron, nitrogen, and silicon. It turns out that we humans are made of the things that there is most of in the universe. This means we seem to be made of the elements that the universe is best at producing. And maybe that's not so odd. There's also a lot of chemistry that goes into this. For example, which elements are better at reacting and forming chemical bonds? There's a lot of helium in the universe compared to the other elements, but helium is what we call a noble gas and does not bind to anything else. All life on Earth is carbon-based. However, silicon is also very abundant in the universe, and it belongs to the same group as carbon in the periodic table. It could be that alien life, if it exists, is silicon-based and not carbon-based. I'm not entirely sure what that would look like, though. Who knows? Maybe Earth's first visitors will let us test their chemical makeup. Thanks for watching Space with Sarah. If you're still curious about the universe, please subscribe to the channel. And as always, keep wondering.